Greetings, fellow warriors, and welcome back to another Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord update video. Taywords has blessed us once again with a quite decent update, I've gotta say. We've got new armor, of course, for Britannia. Some siege fixes and another huge, heh, get it, feature for the game. And I literally say this every time I make one of these videos. I won't go through all the changes, only the most important stuff, in my opinion, will be covered here to keep the video short and digestible. And without further ado, let's dive in to the patch notes. As always, the game received numerous crash, bug and performance fixes that are always nice to see, which I did notice during Siege gameplay. It ran way better than before. Regarding the art direction, they've added 9 new Britannian helmets. The fringed steel cap with cheek guards, which looks like this, as well as a bronze version. The ridged decorated steel cap with cheek guards and its bronze version too. The fringed decorated steel cap with cheek guards as well as a copper version, and a steel and bronze cap with cheek guards too. Body armor weights have been recalibrated according to armor types and armor values. Finally, they're looking at the armor values. Maybe this means that looters can't stone you to death anymore, all while wearing the best armor the player can afford. Armor pieces now no longer have adjectives which define the origin. For example, Southern Helmet, Northern Helmet, etc. The Northern Coat of Plates body armor is now simply called Coat of Plates. They've added 3 new cheering animation variations to the game. Different cheering animations will now play depending on the result of the battle. If it was a close battle, you see these new animations. Here's some of them in action, and I gotta say, they look way, way better than what we had before. They now behave like humans, being thankful and looking into the sky, because no one chopped their head off. I hope we get to use them as the player ourselves as well. During my testing, it seems that we still have the old ones, which don't look too bad, but seeing these new ones really makes me wish for them to be added for the player too. They improved some of the Vlanian settlement models and textures. Regarding the UI, Taywords has implemented a new casualty report option for non-hero troop kills and deaths. It's a variant without the troop name, and I really like this change. And that they added it with an option to revert back to the old report system is just beautiful for those of you who want to see who killed whom. A new option has been added to automatically track attacked settlements, which, well, auto-tracks settlements in the player's faction that are under attack, simply. The only leader option only tracks these settlements if the player is the leader of a faction. Now, the main feature this patch has added is the option to pillage settlements you've just conquered. Players and AI can now choose to devastate, pillage or show mercy to settlements that have been successfully sieged. Devastate and pillage can damage the prosperity rating and projects of the settlement, as well as diminish the power of notables in towns. Naturally, the previous settlement owner won't be too happy about the destruction of their now former home. However, the participants of the siege will see their coffers and party morale rise. Still, lords and ladies may or may not approve of such an action, depending on their traits. The show mercy option allows the winners to take over the settlement without causing too much harm to it or its inhabitants. I guess that's what we had beforehand. While this is expected for settlements of one's own faction culture, showing mercy to foreign settlements will cause unrest among the troops. Just as with the other choices, some nobles will approve or disapprove this action, again, depending on their traits. Now, this feature really sounds promising, especially because the AI can utilize this too, making big changes to power dynamics, relationships and the general option of having a choice when sieging settlements. They've improved the battle formation spawn system. Now, formations will spawn within one of 4 flanks during open field battles. Infantry, heavy infantry and skirmishers now spawn in the center flank. Ranged and civilian units in the rear flank. Cavalry and heavy cavalry will spawn on the left flank. And horse archers as well as light cavalry on the right. Previously, these spawns were all over the place. It's good to know that they look into this and try to improve. Regarding the character development system, they've added all of the remaining combat-related engineering perks, which were 10 in total, and added 2 completely new perks for us to use. Pick them off the walls, which gives you a 25% chance to do double the damage to either siege defenders or attackers. And the make them pay perk makes you deal 25% more damage to defender siege engines and 20 to besieger siege equipment too. Regarding kingdoms and diplomacy, when a settlement's diplomatic state is changed, all hostile parties that are inside will now leave the settlement, and all hostile heroes without parties will be taken as prisoners. The War and Peace AI has been improved so that clans make more logical war and peace declarations. Kingdoms further apart tend to avoid war, peace, and tribute deals between each other, in most cases. Regarding settlement actions, Hetman Notables who have 200 or more power now provide elite troops, and Notables at villages which are bound by a castle now gain more power each day compared to others. Regarding combat changes, cavalry troops got quite the attention this patch. They've improved cavalry calculations to take velocity into consideration when switching to two-handed polearm weapons, and they'll no longer needlessly change weapons when moving short distances or rotating their mounts. They also revised the weapon score calculation. Now units choose between multiple polearms more effectively and take the enemy's armor into account when selecting a weapon. It's nice to see the AI actually growing a brain and behave accordingly when they see someone in full armor charging them. Still, I think they first have to fix the armor calculation, since you can still just use cut weapons and sweep through any armor you see. And that's it for this patch rundown. I've gotta say, I'm really impressed. First we had rebellions, then child education, and now we have pillaging options for settlements after successful sieges. And I can't wait to see what else they have in store for us. I know they have prison break quests and keep battles in the works, but still, very curious what comes next. What do you think? As always, there will be a link in the description leading to the actual patch notes, where you can look up every change they've made. If you like this video, please hit that like button. That would help tremendously. And if you like what I do in general, consider subscribing to the channel. That would also be pretty epic. Join my Discord server, where you can talk with me and other people about all kinds of stuff. And don't forget to join the giveaway I have currently going. Link for that will also be in the description. But other than that, I see you all in the next one. Stay safe, warriors, and bye!